Hello everyone, this is JD Hilberry. I want to let everyone know that my next full-length tutorial will be about drawing realistic-looking animal fur, and I'd like to share some of the ideas and techniques it will include. I'm hoping you'll find this helpful even if you don't end up getting this tutorial. First of all, animal fur is very similar to drawing human hair. So many of the techniques and concepts are the same, but there are significant differences. Just because you can draw a realistic-looking head of hair doesn't mean you'll be successful with animal fur. So here are some of the differences. When we draw a human portrait, we're usually rendering hair only on the top and sides of the head, so the underlying form is a simple sphere. With animal fur, the fur is everywhere and must conform to a much more complicated form. And if you're drawing more than a headshot of the animal, you'll also have to deal with rendering fur as it grows around cylindrical shapes like legs. The length and direction the fur is growing is also much more varied than human hair. In one little area, you may have to render every conceivable direction of the fur. Now I'd like to mention some of the similarities of drawing fur and human hair. If you have my Drawing Realistic Hair tutorial, you learned that regardless of the color of the hair, the lines and darker values you put down on the paper represent the spaces between the hair and not the hair. If you ever try to draw human hair or animal fur using dark pencil lines to represent the individual strands, you're making a huge mistake. And that's the main reason you're probably not happy with the results. The reason so many people try to represent hair and fur this way is that we tend to think that we have the perfect instrument for this type of texture. We know that hair consists of many, many little strands that add up to create a full head of hair. So naturally, we think, perfect, my pencil is great at drawing thin lines, and it should be fairly easy to draw a whole lot of them. But if you use your eyes and objectively examine what the texture looks like, you'll notice that the strands we see are not thin, dark lines that could be represented with lots of pencil lines. And this is true with fur regardless of the animal. The individual hair strands are actually made up of thin white lines. The dark values in lines are the shapes and shaded values between the lighter strands of fur that is catching the light. Now, there are a few exceptions to this rule. Individual strands of stray hair or fur that's visible against a lighter background will be rendered with dark lines. For instance, when dark fur is in front of a lighter patch of fur, or when the very edge of the subject is against a lighter background. After you grasp the concept of creating white lines to represent the fur instead of dark ones, you can use this knowledge to help you draw fur without any reference photo or to help in situations where your reference photo isn't very detailed. Now, some of my drawing students may recognize this guy from my live workshops. He's traveled with me all over the country and even poses with the students at the end of the class. I'll be using photos of him, even as a puppy, along with other high-resolution photos of various types of fur. I'll cover lots of different types of fur. Light, dark, long, short, curly, straight, light against dark, dark against light, and anything else I can think of. You'll be able to download all these reference photographs, and after printing them out, you'll follow along as I demonstrate some uncommon techniques I use to accurately capture these textures. Now, even though fur will be the focus of this tutorial, I'll also demonstrate how to draw other distinguishing features of animals. You'll learn how to easily render the unique texture of a nose, and to give it the contrast needed to make it appear as real as possible. I've always been fascinated with the eyes of animals. Looking deep into the eyes of an animal gives us a sense of familiarity and an unspoken connection. And I always get the sense that this feeling is mutual. It's been said that the eyes are the window to the soul, and I'll show you the best ways to capture that feeling in your drawings. So, I hope you found this video helpful, and I also hope you'll keep a lookout announcing the release of this new tutorial. After going through these lessons, you'll know all the concepts and techniques you'll need to draw any of your furry friends. Until next time, keep drawing!